Dear friends and students, today I am going to speak on a very important aspect or subtopic under the title Introduction to Economics of Environment, that is Sustainable Development. All of us know we are in the era of sustainable development, and we want sustainable development than economic growth or development. And therefore, it requires to analyze and discuss what sustainable development is and why it is preferred to economic growth or economic development. In addition to that, is there a nexus, is there a relationship between sustainable development and economic growth or economic development? And what indicators can be used so as to estimate and measure sustainable development? What is meant by sustainable development? Are there any dimensions of sustainable development? These are some of the very important issues which are necessary to be studied while talking about sustainable development in particular and economics of environment in general. Therefore, in today's lecture, I will try to explain what is meant by sustainable development, how it is different from economic growth and development, what indicators or parameters are there so as to measure sustainable development. Can there be a weak sustainability and strong sustainability? What can be dimensions of sustainable development? These are some of the very important things relating to sustainable development that I want to speak with you. This is my plan of lecture so far as the aspect or component of sustainable development is concerned. I will explain this with the help of a PowerPoint presentation so that everybody will be in a position to understand the various issues relating to sustainable development. Already I have mentioned that we are in the era of sustainable development, and therefore what sustainable development is, that is very much necessary to be discussed and analyzed. Some of the very important definitions of sustainable development are there, and those try to explain what is meant by sustainable development. The World Commission on Environment and Development, which has given a report known as Brundtland Report, and for the first time it tries to define the term sustainable development. It says sustainable development is that development which meets the needs of the present without compromising the availability of future generations to meet their own needs. What does this mean? This means that it is necessary to provide for fulfillment of wants of the people, needs of the people, but those in the present should not be at the cost of future. A balance between future and present should be there so as to fulfill needs or wants of the people, and for that reason, whatever the resources, productive resources are required, those should be allocated and utilized in such a manner as the result of that wants of the people at present as well as in the future will be satisfied, and that is expected, required so far as sustainable development is concerned. Now, David Pearce has given a very comprehensive definition of sustainable development. He says, sustainable development is a vector of desirable social objectives such as increase in real per capita income, improvement in health and nutrition, educational achievement, access to resources, a fairer distribution of income, increase in basic freedom. All these are the characteristics or properties of sustainable development. Yes, it's a coefficient, it's a value of all social objectives, and that should be realized, that should be achieved. And when in that direction the efforts are being made by a particular economy, by a particular country, that phenomenon of the development is known as sustainable development. Thus, according to Pierre, so as to realize sustainable development for a particular country. What is required? It is required increase in real per capita income. It is required improvement in nutrition and health, educational achievement, access to resources, fairer distribution of income, increase in freedom. These are the things which are required so as to realize sustainable development. Likewise, David and Pierce, Edward Barbier, and in Markandeya, they also try to define the term sustainable development. According to them, sustainable development means we summarize the necessary conditions for sustainable development as constancy of the natural capital stock, more strictly the requirements as and for non-negative changes in the stock of natural resources such as soil, soil quality, ground surface waters, air quality, land biomass, water biomass, waste assimilation capacity, etc. All these things consolidatedly, integratedly require so far as sustainable development concept is concerned. Now, once we understand the concept of sustainable development, then the question of problem arises is how to measure sustainable development. And so as to solve this question, answer this question, indicators or parameters of sustainable development have been developed, have been proposed. Those are basically classified into two categories. Number one is Professor Bhartwa of IIT Kanpur. He has given certain indicators or parameters of sustainable development. In addition to that, United Nations organization has a separate department for sustainable development, policy coordination. And it has also given certain indicators of sustainable development. Now, Professor Bhartwal says, sustainable development can be measured using growth in GDP or growth rate of GDP, increase in GDP, stability in population, human resource development index, that is whether GDP is growing, whether population of a country is stable or it is increasing rapidly, what is the status of human resource development that can be measured by making use of HDI index, what is clean air index, what is purity of air, what extent air is pure, what is the use of energy, what is magnitude or intensity of use of the energy, then in the total energy use, what is the proportion of renewable energy use, hydro energy can be there, solar energy can be there, wind energy can be there, what is the intensity of use of materials, how much magnitude or in what magnitude material means productive resources are used, what is intensity, that is here it is expected that the intensity of use of materials should be less, it should not be excessive. Water use should be minimal, it should be only as per requirements and it should not be excessive. Soil degradation should not take place, soil erosion should not take place, the soil pollution problem should not be there. Forest coverage, each and every country should have a forest coverage and it should be at least one third, that is 33% of the total geographical area covered by that nation. Recycling, what is the magnitude of waste, solid waste generated is recycled, what is the magnitude of wastewater generated is recycled. Then what is transport intensity, what is availability of the transport facilities, what's it use, that intensity of transport use. That is according to Professor Bhartwa, GDP growth rate, population stability, human resource development index, clean air index, energy intensity, renewable energy proportion, material intensity, use of water, soil degradation, forest coverage, recycle of solid and liquid waste, transport intensity. These are the indicators. Those can be used for measuring or estimating sustainable development of the economy. The United Nations Department for Policy Coordination and Sustainable Development has also given certain indicators or parameters so as to measure sustainable development of the economy. They are GDP per capita, that is what is rate of increase in GDP per capita, net investment share in GDP, how much investment in proportion of the GDP is being invested in the economy. What is the exports and imports, total of exports and imports as a percentage of GDP, how much international trade participation as a share of GDP is there. Environmentally adjusted net domestic product, all of us know net domestic product, that is from GDP when we deduct depreciation of capital assets or capital goods, what remains is known as national domestic product, NDP. And from that, when we deduct environmental cost, that is cost of environmental pollution control and depletion in the natural resources or environmental resources, the total is known as environmental cost. And when we deduct, that is degradation in the natural resources, environmental resources, and depletion, magnitude of depletion in the natural resources, when it is deducted, what it remains is known as environmentally adjusted net domestic product. And it is more connected with the sustainable development than the net domestic product. What is the exports, share of exports in total trade in comparison with the gross domestic product? What is the magnitude of annual energy consumption? How much energy is consumed? Then industries which use natural resources, what is the intensity of those industries in manufacturing sector? How much they add value to the manufacturing sector? What is the availability of mineral resources, mineral reserves in the country? What is the availability of fossil fuel energy resource, coal is there, petrol is there, diesel is there, crude oil is there? What is the total availability of energy resources, total amount of natural resources which produce energy that can be produced? Then intensity of material use, how much material is used and how much, what is the number of such industries? Then share of manufacturing in the gross domestic product manufacturing sector. Proportion of consumption of renewable energy resources in the total. Then what is the resource transfer to gross national product percentage? How much resources are transferred to others and its proportion to the gross national product? What is overseas development assistance given or received from foreign countries to our country as a percentage of GDP? How much environmental expenditure is incurred and what's its percentage, what's its proportion to the gross domestic product? What is the amount of additional funding for sustainable development? Whether sustainable development fund is created, how much amount it is there? Capital goods imports, how much capital goods are being imported? What is the magnitude and trends in foreign direct investment into a country like us? Likewise, what is share of environmental sound capital goods imports? When we import capital goods, what is proportion of environmentally sound capital goods, that is of crucial importance? And here it is expected that that should be more, that should be maximum extent possible. How much technical development grants are being given, technical cooperation grants are being given? The sum totality of that gives us indicators or parameters of estimating measuring sustainable development of a country. Thus, according to United Nations Organization, GDP per capita, net investment share in GDP, sum of exports and imports as percentage of GDP, environmentally adjusted net domestic product, share of exports, annual energy consumption, share of natural intensive industries in manufacturing value added, proven mineral reserves, proven fossil energy reserves, lifetime proven energy reserves, industry, intensity of material use, industry of intensity of material use, share of manufacturing value added in GDP, share of consumption of renewable energy resources, net resource transfer to GNP, total overseas development assistance given or received as percentage of GDP, environmental protection expenditure as a percentage of GDP, amount of new or additional funding for sustainable development, capital goods imports, foreign direct investment, Capture of environmentally sound capital inputs and technical cooperation grants are used or can be useful in measuring or estimating sustainable development of a particular country or the country. Now, sustainable development can be strong or weak. And how to measure that? Pearson Atkinson have given formula or equation so as to measure sustainable development, whether it is weak or strong. Actually, for that reason, what is required? It is required to take into account classification of capital or productive resources, which is mainly classified into three categories: man-made capital, natural capital, human capital. In man-made capital, we have machines, buildings, roads. In natural capital, renewable and non-renewable resources. In human capital, money and skills. And when this classification is taken into account, then we can arrive at whether sustainable development is weak or strong. Pearson Atkinson says when J is coefficient of sustainable development is equal to savings divided by national income, that is ratio of savings to income minus depreciation in man-made capital, its ratio to national income minus depreciation in natural capital, its proportion to income. When it is calculated, and Z, that is coefficient of sustainable development, its value is greater than 0 or equal to 0, it is known as weak sustainability. It is called as weak sustainable development. On the contrary, only natural capital is taken into account. Its depreciation and ratio to income is taken into account. And when its value, that is that J, coefficient of sustainable development, is less than 0 or equal to 0, it is known as strong sustainability. That is, what is the difference? Difference is that in weak sustainable development, all resources, especially man-made resources and natural resources, are taken into account. But in strong sustainable development, only in depletion in natural capital or natural resources is taken into account. And that gives us whether sustainable development is strong or weak. Here it is expected that depletion in all the productive resources should be the minimum, but the depletion in the natural resources should be very less, very minimal. That is expected so far as strong sustainable development and weak sustainable development is concerned. Now, we can look at sustainable development in different perspectives. And there are prominently four perspectives looking towards the sustainable development. We may describe them as dimensions of sustainable development or aspects of sustainable development. One is economic, second is social, third is environmental, and fourth is institutional. In economic dimension, there should be optimal flow of income in the economy, but maintaining stock of man-made capital, human capital, natural capital is very much necessary. And cost of production should include environmental cost, along with production cost and consumption cost. This gives us what we call it as the economic dimension of sustainable development. That is, flow of income should be generated, but stock of man-made capital, human capital, natural capital should maintain. Cost of production, consumption, and environmental cost should be taken into account. And environmental cost means cost of control of environmental pollution and cost on compensation to the victims of environmental pollution. In social dimension, we should attempt for maintaining justice and equity. There should be health, resources, and opportunity to be equally shared. All citizens should have access to minimum security, human rights, social benefits such as good health, education, shelter, self-development opportunities. And here, social equity means equal opportunities for education, productive contribution to society. Environmental dimension is very important, which expects there should be sustainable use, that is economical, rational use of environmental resources. Efficient sink function should be performed. And maintaining of stock of natural capital is very much necessary. There should not be any inefficiencies, interruptions in the working of ecology or ecological stability. That is, use of the resources should be sustainable. There should be efficiency in function, and stock of natural capital should be maintained. The sum totality of that gives us an environmental dimension of sustainable development. In institutional dimension, there should be sustainable development strategy in the country. That country should participate in global agreements relating to sustainable development. There should be use of internet subscribers, use of telephone. Expenditure on development and research should be there, and what's its proportion to GDP. And human and economic costs during natural disasters should be minimal, should be lesser. Like that of sustainable development, there can be non-sustainability or unsustainable development. And how to measure non-sustainability? There are some indicators, those have been given, so as to measure non-sustainability in the development. When level of water falls, when pollution, air, water increases continuously, degradation of land is rapid, it is taking place frequently and continuously. There is decrease in the availability of fishery resources that is there. And natural calamities are continuously increasing. Flood is there, cyclone is there, drought is there, excess of rainfall is there. Well, all these are being observed frequently, continuously. Those are indicators of non-sustainable development. Indicators of non-sustainable development. Thus, in sustainable development, these are some of the very important things which are necessary to be taken into account when we talk about sustainable development. Already I have mentioned that in sustainable development, we are in the era of sustainable development and not in the era of economic development. And when talking about sustainable development, we should take into account the concept of sustainable development. And the concept of sustainable development that we can get acquainted with, that we can understand. By taking into account different definitions of sustainable development, like that of definition given by Brundtland Report or World Commission on Environment and Development. David Pearce has given very important definition of sustainable development. Pearce, Barbier, Markandale, they also have defined the concept of sustainable development. And so as to solve the problem of question of how to measure sustainable development, Professor Bhartwal of IIT Kanpur, he has given not 12 indicators of sustainable development. He can say parameters of sustainable development, that is GDP growth rate, population stability, human resource development index, clean air index, energy intensity, renewable energy proportion, material intensity, water use, soil degradation, forest coverage, recycling proportion, transport intensity. More importantly, United Nations Department for Policy Coordination and Sustainable Development has given even 21 indicators or parameters. Those are GDP per capita, net investment share in GDP, sum of exports and import as a percentage of GDP, environmental adjusted net domestic product, share of exports, annual energy consumption, share of natural resource intensive industries in manufacturing value added, proven mineral reserves, proven fossil fuel energy reserves, lifetime proven energy reserves, intensity, industry intensity of metal use, share of manufacturing value added in GDP, share of consumption of renewable energy resources, net resource transfer to GNP, total overseas development assistance given or received and its proportion to GDP. Environmental protection expenditure as a percentage of GDP, amount of new or additional funding for sustainable development, capital goods imports, foreign direct investment, share of environmentally sound capital goods imports, technical cooperation grants. Development, sustainable development can be strong or weak. Pearce and Atkinson have given index or indicator. It is based on the type of productive resources considered. When we consider human capital, man-made capital, natural capital, and the value is greater than zero or equal to zero, it is weak sustainability. On the contrary, just we consider natural resources and the depletion that has taken place, then it is considered, if it is less than 0 or equal to 0, it is strong sustainable development. That is depletion in all the resources, man-made or natural resources. That should be the least, that should be the minimum. And when it is just taken in the context of natural capital, natural resources, it is called a strong sustainable development. We can look at sustainable development in four dimensions: economic dimension, social dimension, environmental dimension, and institutional dimension. In economic dimension, flow of income, stock of man-made capital, human capital, natural capital, cost of production, consumption, and environmental protection. In social social dimension, justice and equity, health, resources, that should be given. Then access to human rights, social benefits like food, health, education, shelter, self-development should be given. Environmental, sustainable use of resources, efficient sink function, maintenance of stock of natural capital, environment should function efficiently, that's required. In institutional dimension, we should adopt sustainable development strategy, we should participate in global agreements, we should have more number of internet subscribers, telephone lines, telephone facilities should be available, expenditure on development research should be, when it is considered as percentage of GDP, that should be considerable. Human and economic loss during natural disaster should be minimal, that is there. So sustainable development can be non-sustainable. And how to measure that unsustainability or non-sustainability in development? That is also crucial importance. When water level falls continuously rapidly, when air pollution, water pollution increases continuously rapidly, land degradation is more in the form of soil erosion, desertification of land, water logging, food shortage is there, food grains production is not sufficient and adequate, fishery resource availability has decreased very rapidly and significantly, and natural calamities are continuously and frequently being experienced. Those are having shown increasing trend. Flood is there, cyclone is there, earthquake is there, tsunami is there. That's an indicator of unsustainability in development that is there. And these are the very important things which are necessary to be considered when we want to talk about sustainable development. Thus, in sustainable development, many indicators of sustainable development, dimensions of sustainable development, and unsustainability or non-sustainability in development. These are the important things which are necessary to be taken into account so far as sustainable development is considered, is to be taken into account. Upon as Chirantan Kiva Shashwat Vikasacha Yogatam, as a pillar Arthi Purti Kiva Arthi Vikasna Paya, pillar Shashwat Vikas Kiva Chirantan Vikas Paya. But the name Kashashwat Vikas Kiva Chirantan Vikas Mujinemka Kaya. तर हे समजून घेणं अत्यंत आवश्यक आहे. आणि पर्यावरणाच्या अर्थशास्त्रामध्ये हा अभ्यासाला खूप महत्वाचं स्थान आहे असं आपल्याला म्हणता येईल. तर शाश्वत विकास, चिरंतन विकास समजावून घेत असताना त्याची संकल्पना, तो मोजायचा कसा, त्याचे मापदंड, निदर्शक, तर शाश्वत विकास दुर्बळ प्रबळ असू शकतो का ते विचारात घेणे, शाश्वत विकासाचे काही पैलू आहेत का विचारांमध्ये घेणे, आणि हा विकास नेहमी शाश्वत असेल असं नाही, तो अशाश्वत सुद्धा असू शकतो. मग तो अशाश्वत असला तर कसं नेमका आपण मोजायचा, या गोष्टींचा विचार आपल्याला करणं आवश्यक आहे. म्हणजे आपण शाश्वत विकास म्हणजे काय, शाश्वत विकासाचा दुर्बळ शाश्वत विकास आणि प्रबळ शाश्वत विकास म्हणजे काय, शाश्वत विकासाचे मापदंड किंवा निदर्शक, शाश्वत विकासाचे पैलू, दोन डायमेन्शन्स, आणि शाश्वत अशाश्वत विकासाचं मी तर्फे किंवा मापदंड याचा विचार त्यांनी करता. शाश्वत विकासाचा विचार करताना पर्यावरण विकास याविषयीचे जे जागतिक आयोग आहे त्यांनी जो ब्रुनल्यांचा अहवाल सादर केला त्यांनी शाश्वत विकासाची संकल्पना सांगितलेली आहे. त्या व्याख्याप्रमाणे भविष्यकालीन लोकांच्या गरजा भागविण्यावरती प्रतिकूल परिणाम न करता वर्तमानकालीन लोकांच्या गरजा भागवण्याचा प्रयत्न करणं म्हणजे शाश्वत विकास. याचा अर्थ असा की जे उत्पादनाची साधनं आहेत प्रामुख्याने नैसर्गिक किंवा पर्यावरणीय संसाधन आहेत त्यांचा वापर आणि वाटप आपण अशा पद्धतीने करायला पाहिजे की वर्तमानकालीन लोकांच्या गरजा भागवण्याबरोबरच भविष्यकालीन लोकांच्या गरजा सुद्धा आपल्याला भागवता येतील. त्या दृष्टीने आपण प्रयत्न करून म्हणजे शाश्वत विकास आपल्याला म्हणताय. डेव्हिड पियर्स यांनी शाश्वत विकासाची सुंदर व्याख्या दिलेली आहे. ते असं म्हणतात की वास्तू दृढ उत्पन्न वाढणं, आरोग्य आणि पोषण सुधारणं, शैक्षणिक प्रगती होणं, संसाधनांचा वापर करणं, उत्पन्नाचं योग्य पद्धतीनं समाजातील लोकांमध्ये वाटप करणं, स्वातंत्र्य देणं, या सगळ्यांना एकत्रितरित्या आपण शाश्वत विकास असं म्हणावं असं डेव्हिड पियर्स यांनी सांगितलेलं आहे. त्याच पद्धतीने पियर्स, बॅरबियर आणि मार्कंडे यांनी सुद्धा शाश्वत विकासाची व्याख्या देण्याचा प्रयत्न केला. त्यांनी असं सांगितलं की नैसर्गिक भांडवलाचा साठा राखून ठेवणे, भांडवलाच्या नैसर्गिक भांडवलामध्ये किंवा संसाधनामध्ये प्रतिकूल बदल न होणं, जसं की जमिनीची धूप, जमिनीचं प्रदूषण, पाण्याचं प्रदूषण, घनकचरा, द्रव कचरा आणि पर्यावरणावर होणारा प्रतिकूल परिणाम न होणं, असा जर आपण प्रयत्न करत गेलो तर आपल्याला शाश्वत विकास ही संकल्पना समजू शकते किंवा या संकल्पनेला आपण शाश्वत विकास असं म्हणावं असं आपल्याला म्हणतो. मग हा चिरंतन किंवा शाश्वत विकास मोजायचा कसा, त्याचे मापदंड किंवा निदर्शक प्राध्यापक भरतवाल, आय आय टी कानपूर आणि संयुक्त राष्ट्रसंघाने दिलेले आहे. प्राध्यापक भरतवाल असं म्हणतात की स्थूल देशांतर्गत उत्पादन वाढत असेल, लोकसंख्येचं स्थैर्य प्रस्थापित झालं असेल, मानव संसाधनं विकसित होत असतील, शुद्ध हवा शुद्ध असेल, ऊर्जेच्या वापराची तीव्रता अधिक असेल, प्रमाण अधिक असेल, नूतनीकरणक्षम ऊर्जेचा वापर अधिक असेल, संसाधनाच्या वापराची तीव्रता कमी असेल, पाण्याचा वापर काटकसरीनं मर्यादित असेल, जमिनीची किंवा मातीची धूप किंवा ऱ्हास कमी होत असेल, जंगल व्याप्त क्षेत्र आवश्यक असेल म्हणजे एकूण भौगोलिक क्षेत्राच्या 1/3 म्हणजे 33% असेल, घनकचरा किंवा सांड पाण्याचं पुनर्चक्रीकरण होत असेल त्याचं प्रमाण अधिक असेल आणि ज्या वाहतूक सुविधा आहे त्या वाहतूक सुविधांची उपलब्धता सुद्धा मोठ्या प्रमाणावरती चांगल्या प्रमाणावरती आहे. हे जर सगळं आपल्याला एखाद्या देशामध्ये एखाद्या राष्ट्रामध्ये दिसत असेल तर त्याला आपण असं म्हणावं की तो शाश्वत विकास साध्य करत आहे, शाश्वत विकास होत आहे. संयुक्त राष्ट्रसंघाने शाश्वत विकास मोजायचा किंवा त्याचे निदर्शक त्याचे मापदंड 19 सांगितलेले आहे. संयुक्त राष्ट्रसंघामध्ये चिरंतन विकासासाठी एक स्वतंत्र खाता आहे, विभाग आहे आणि त्यांना हे मापदंड किंवा निदर्शक दिलेले आहे. ते असं म्हणतात की तुमचं स्थूल देशांतर्गत दरडी उत्पादन वाढायला पाहिजे, तुमच्या भांडवल देशामध्ये वाढायला पाहिजे आणि त्याचं स्थूल देशांतर्गत उत्पादनाचे प्रमाण अधिक असलं पाहिजे, निर्यात आणि आयातीचं प्रमाण किती तुमचं स्थूल देशांतर्गत उत्पादनाचे ते अधिक असायला पाहिजे, तुमचं पर्यावरण अंतर्भूत निव्वळ देशांतर्गत उत्पादन किती आहे, आपल्याला निव्वळ देशांतर्गत उत्पादन माहीत आहे पण पर्यावरण अंतर्गत निव्वळ देशांतर्गत उत्पादन ही संकल्पना आपल्याला माहीत नाही. आपण जेव्हा स्थूल देशांतर्गत उत्पादनातून GDP मधून भांडवली वस्तूंवरचा घसारा वजा करतो तेव्हा आपल्याला निव्वळ देशांतर्गत उत्पादन मिळतं आणि त्यातून आपण नैसर्गिक संसाधनाचा ऱ्हास किती झाला आणि नैसर्गिक संसाधनं किती घटली हे जर वजा केलं तर जे शिल्लक राहतं त्याला आपण पर्यावरण अंतर्गत निव्वळ देशांतर्गत उत्पादन असं आपण म्हणतो. तुमची एकूण निर्यात किती आहे, त्याचं प्रमाण किती आहे, ऊर्जेचा वार्षिक उपभोग किंवा सेवन किती आहे, वस्तू निर्माण क्षेत्रामध्ये नैसर्गिक संसाधनाचा अधिक वापर करणाऱ्या उद्योगांचं प्रमाण किती आहे, देशामध्ये खनिजाचं साठे किती आहे, जीवाश्म इंधनाचे साठे किती आहेत, एकूण ऊर्जेचे साठे देशामध्ये किती आहेत, अधिक असावेत अशी अपेक्षा आहे. उत्पादन साधनांच्या वापराची तीव्रता उद्योगामध्ये किती आहे, वस्तू निर्माण क्षेत्राचं योगदान स्थूल देशांतर्गत उत्पादनामध्ये किती आहे, एकूण ऊर्जेच्या सेवनामध्ये नूतनीकरणक्षम ऊर्जेच्या सेवनाचं प्रमाण किती आहे, तुमच्या देशातून संसाधनाचा स्थलांतरण किती होतं त्याचं प्रमाण किती आहे स्थूल राष्ट्रीय उत्पादनाशी, परदेशामध्ये तुम्ही किती मदत दिली किंवा परदेशातून किती मदत स्वीकारली आणि त्याचं प्रमाण स्थूल देशांतर्गत उत्पादनाशी किती आहे, तुम्ही पर्यावरणाच्या संरक्षणावरती किती खर्च करता त्याचं स्थूल देशांतर्गत उत्पादनाशी प्रमाण किती आहे, तुम्ही नवीन एखादा निधी चिरंतन विकासासाठी निर्माण केला आहे का, तो किती रकमेचा आहे, त्याची रक्कम किती आहे, तुम्ही भांडवली वस्तूंची आयात करता का, ती करावीशी अपेक्षा, तुमच्या देशामध्ये थेट परकीय गुंतवणूक किती आहे, त्या अधिक आहे का कमी आहे, तुम्ही जे भांडवली वस्तूंची आयात करता ते पर्यावरणपूरक आहे का, पर्यावरणावरती घातक परिणाम करणार नाही का, ती दक्षता घ्यायला पाहिजे. तांत्रिक प्रगती तंत्रज्ञानाच्या विकासासाठी तुम्ही किती मदत देता, किती अनुदान देता याचा विचार सुद्धा आपण केला तर शाश्वत किंवा चिरंतन विकासाचं मापन किंवा मोजमाप ही आपल्याला करता येईल. आता हा जो शाश्वत विकास आहे तो कदाचित दुर्बल किंवा प्रबळ असू शकतो आणि ती संकल्पना त्याचं मोजमाप करण्यासाठी पियर्स आणि ॲटकिन्सन यांनी एक निर्देशांक दिलेला आहे किंवा एक निदर्शक दिलेला आहे. अर्थात त्यासाठी हे जे उत्पादन संसाधन आहेत किंवा ज्याला आपण भांडवल असं म्हणतो त्याचं वर्गीकरण विचारामध्ये घेतलेलं आहे. मानवनिर्मित भांडवल, यंत्रे, इमारती, रस्ते, नैसर्गिक भांडवल, नूतनीकरणक्षम संसाधन, मानवी भांडवल, ज्ञान आणि कौशल्य, बचत, उत्पन्न, हे सगळे विचारामध्ये घेतलेलं आहे. जेव्हा आपण बचतीचं राष्ट्रीय उत्पन्नाशी प्रमाण विचारात घेतली त्यातून मानवनिर्मित भांडवलाचा झालेला घसारा किंवा त्याची घट त्याचं प्रमाण राष्ट्रीय उत्पन्नाशी विचारात घेतलं त्यातून नैसर्गिक संसाधनांमध्ये झालेली घर त्याचं राष्ट्रीय उत्पन्नाचे प्रमाण विचारात घेतलं आणि त्याचं उत्तर शून्यापेक्षा अधिक आलं किंवा शून्याबरोबर आलं तर अशा प्रकारची जी शाश्वतता आहे त्याला आपण दुर्बल शाश्वतता वीक सस्टेनेबिलिटी असं आपण म्हणतो. त्याउलट नुसतं आपण नैसर्गिक संसाधनाचा विचार केला आणि त्यामध्ये झालेली घट ऱ्हास त्याचं राष्ट्रीय उत्पन्नाचे प्रमाण विचारात घेतलं आणि त्याचं उत्तर जर शून्य बरोबर आलं किंवा शून्यापेक्षा कमी आलं तर त्याला आपण प्रबळ शाश्वतता असं आपण म्हणतो. म्हणजे दुर्बळ शाश्वततेमध्ये मानवनिर्मित भांडवल आणि नैसर्गिक भांडवल यातली घट विचारामध्ये याचा ऱ्हास विचारात घेतला जातो तर प्रबळ शाश्वततेमध्ये नैसर्गिक भांडवल त्यामध्ये झालेला ऱ्हास त्यामध्ये झालेली घट आपण विचारात घेतो. चिरंतन विकासाकडे आपण चार दृष्टिकोनातून चार पैलूतून बघू शकतो. आर्थिक दृष्टिकोन, सामाजिक दृष्टिकोन, पर्यावरणीय दृष्टिकोन आणि संस्थात्मक दृष्टिकोन. आर्थिक दृष्टिकोनामध्ये तुमच्या देशामध्ये उत्पन्न निर्मिती व्हायला पाहिजे पण त्याच वेळेला मानवनिर्मित भांडवल, मानव भांडवल, नैसर्गिक भांडवल याचे साठे तुम्ही राखून ठेवायला पाहिजे. उत्पादन खर्च, उपभोग खर्च आणि पर्यावरण संरक्षणाचा खर्च तुम्ही विचारात घ्यायला पाहिजे. सामाजिक दृष्टिकोनामध्ये न्याय आणि समता तुम्ही राखायला पाहिजे. आरोग्य, संसाधने आणि संधी याचं वाटप समान पद्धतीने करायला पाहिजे. सुरक्षितता हक्क द्यायला पाहिजे. अन्न, आरोग्य, शिक्षण, निवारा, स्वयंविकासाच्या संधी या द्यायला पाहिजे. हे सगळं आपण एकत्रितरित्या साध्य करण्याचा प्रयत्न करत असू तर त्याला चिरंतन विकासाची सामाजिक बाजू, सामाजिक पैलू असं आपण म्हणतो. पर्यावरणीय बाजू अत्यंत महत्त्वाची आहे. त्यामध्ये संसाधनांचा अत्यंत कार्यक्षम वापर करणं, ते जे घन कचरा आणि द्रव कचरा आणि प्रदूषण जे शोषण घेतात, शोषण करून घेतात, ते जे कार्य पर्यावरण करतं ते अत्यंत कार्यक्षम पद्धतीने व्हायला पाहिजे. नैसर्गिक संसाधनाचे साठे राखून ठेवायला पाहिजे, त्यामध्ये फार भासपूर्त कामं नाही. अशा प्रकारे जर आपण चिरंतन विकासाकडे प्रयत्न करत असू तर त्याला आपण पर्यावरणीय दृष्टिकोनातून चिरंतन विकास असं आपल्याला म्हणता येईल. संस्थात्मक दृष्टिकोनामध्ये आपली विकासाची नीती चिरंतन विकास असायला पाहिजे. आपण जागतिक करारामध्ये सहभागी व्हायला पाहिजे. इंटरनेटचा वापर व्हायला पाहिजे, टेलिफोनचा वापर व्हायला पाहिजे आणि विकास आणि संशोधनावरती खर्च करायला पाहिजे. आणि तेव्हा नैसर्गिक आपत्ती येते त्यामुळे मानवी आणि आर्थिक नुकसान होतं ते कमीत कमी असायला पाहिजे. शाश्वत विकास हा कदाचित अशाश्वत असू शकतो. तो ओळखायचा कसा? पाण्याची पातळी खोलवर जाणं, प्रदूषण, पाणी प्रदूषण, ध्वनी प्रदूषण, हवा प्रदूषण वाढत जाणं, जमिनीचा ऱ्हास वेगानं वाढत जाणं, अन्नधान्याची अन्नाची टंचाई निर्माण होणं, माशांची उपलब्धता कमीत कमी होणं, नैसर्गिक संकट, यामध्ये दुष्काळ असेल, यामध्ये चक्रीवादळ असेल, हे सगळं वाढत जाणं, हे जर आपण अनुभवत असू तर अशा विकासाला आपण अशाश्वत विकास असं पण म्हणावं. म्हणजे शाश्वत विकासाचा विचार करताना त्याची संकल्पना, प्रबळ आणि दुर्बळ शाश्वत विकास, त्याचे निर्देशक मापदंड आणि त्याच्या त्याच्या त्याचे पैलू आणि तो अशाश्वत आहे का, हे सगळं आपण विचारामध्ये घ्यावं लागतं. तस टुडे वी ट्राय फॉर व्हॉट इज सस्टेनेबल डेव्हलपमेंट, व्हॉट इज स्ट्रॉंग सस्टेनेबल डेव्हलपमेंट, वीक सस्टेनेबल डेव्हलपमेंट, व्हॉट आर द इंडिकेटर्स ऑफ सस्टेनेबल डेव्हलपमेंट, व्हॉट आर द डायमेन्शन्स ऑफ सस्टेनेबल डेव्हलपमेंट अँड what are the indicators of unsustainability or unsustainable development. These are some of the very important things which are required to be taken into account when we talk about sustainable development. I hope you will like this lecture.